I think I see something. Here goes nothing.
Terra, you've returned. I knew you could do it.
And I knew I'd seen you somewhere before. I live in Milkwater, my foot.
It's the wild boat. Huh, and look, the wildling.
Ah, Terra, do you have the customary charm?
Oh, here it is. So what does this do, anyway?
Oh, if you break the charm, it reveals your location. A fascinating little gadget.
And if you ever endanger our secrecy here?
We will know exactly where to find you.
But where am I exactly?
Oh, where are our manners? Yes, you're in Ravenwood Hollow, a hidden little home. You already know me as a human, but under the moon, I take a slightly more wolfish form.
You may call me Perry. I'm a fairy, and I run the apothecary. What? It's not even that funny.
We've met, course. Oh, but not formally. I'm Zephyr, of the Grimspark Goblins.
I'm Ariel. I would like you more if you were scaly or furry or had wings, but you'll do.
Wow. I've never seen this place on a map of Fairhaven.
Technically, we're not in Fairhaven. This place exists between a point in the human world, that's Fairhaven, and a point in the Fey world, the Gloaming.
Don't tell me. Another place everyone failed to mention.
Come speak with me later. There are things about the Fey world you must know.
So you are the Fey?
Yes, and we don't let many into our home. Not even all witches.
But you brought me here during the summer festival.
Actually, we haven't been able to untie that particular knot.
What Zephyr means is none of us brought you here. We still don't know how it happened.
Great. Love that there's a unsolved mystery centering around me, being flung through space-time.
Ooh, spicy! Just like your grandmother.
Now that you've been formally received into Ravenwood Hollow, you can come and go as you like. Just remember, never reveal our existence to anyone. You've never been in a real apothecary, have you? This isn't some pharmacy run by mortal doctors. Careful what you touch. I work with sensitive ingredients.
I will. Promise. By the way, what exactly are you, Perry? A pixie?
I am a fairy. To call me diminutive is an insult.
Sorry. I have a lot to learn about Ravenwood Hollow.
Now that is a fact. By the way, thank you for the honey you gave us during the summer festival. Honey makes a perfect reagent.
You're welcome. It's nice to get to know the fairy it went to.
Oh, if you ever need potion supplies, come visit me. My ingredients are the finest in Ravenwood Hollow.
I will. So, were you born in Ravenwood Hollow?
Not at all. I grew up in a tiny town in Alaska, and my parents are decidedly human. The story of how I ended up here is quite complicated.
Oh, gosh, I just love meeting new witches who grew up outside Fairhaven. You must have so many stories about the city.
People keep thinking that, but my life has been 1,000 times more exciting since moving here. Where are you from, Ariel?
It is a place you humans call Brazil. But when I came into being, the humans called it Pindoretama.
That's a long way from here.
One day I may tell you the story of how I came to Ravenwood Hollow.
I could... Is it time for bed? Oof, not a very good day for surfing, huh?
Au contraire, my dude. As long as there's not too much lightning, it's fine to hit the water. I mean, you're already wet, so what's a little rain? You just gotta be careful afterwards. Rain makes all the trash wash up on shore.
Enough to keep me from reaching the pinnacle. Go, with logic in your minds and your eyes on the path.
This is quality stuff. I don't know how I'll make it up to you, Tara.
Hi, Tara. Good to see you here. Do you come often?
Not really.
Well, that's okay. Everyone has to walk the path at their own pace, as Messenger Cameron says. I grew up going to Mass, so it took me a while to feel comfortable here, knowing my parents won't approve. And Francis's snarky remarks don't help.
They'll come around. But I can see why your family and Francis might find the league a bit unusual.
Well, it definitely is new. But they shouldn't be so quick to judge before they've even given it a chance. I think the Book of the Mind can really help people. Look, I feel real acceptance here. Like, I can be in charge of my own destiny, you know? It's about hope.
I'm never quite sure what to do with myself when school's out. Plan Otto's taxes? Organize the closets again? Move ahead on that kitchen renovation?
You could take a real break, just like your students.
Oh no, I'd be terribly bored.
Maresoft, does the new rancher seem a bit odd to you at all?
Huh? Odd? No, he's a bit green, but so were you not long ago, eh, Terra?
I guess that's a good point.
Exactly. He's a totally normal guy who decided to be a rancher out of the blue, and it's our good fortune that he moved here.
I miss you, Grandma.
Perfect for my incantation studies.
You may stare, I have wondrous ankles. This is my watch post. I keep a lookout for wild animals who may be wounded or otherwise in danger. Come visit me if you ever want to learn how to commune with all of nature's creatures.
So, is there a whole colony of goblins living in the mines?
Nah, we never lived in the mines. We need fresh air, just like you folks. But my ancestors did work the deep caves for generations and generations.
Do you ever catch up with your family back in Alaska?
Well, my dad walked out on us when my brother and I were three. Went back to Russia. My mom and I talk, but She also thinks I run a bookstore in Milkwater. I haven't been able to tell her about, you know.
You said a while back that you had something to tell me about the Gloaming?
Yes. The wellspring that you witches balance, it exists in the Fey world. The human world is not itself magical, but magic bubbles up from elsewhere. That's the Gloaming. At its heart is the wellspring.
Oh, but I still have so many questions.
You will have to ask them later. I am a busy fairy.
Should I soak for? I found something! A recipe! Is it a... It is! A recipe! I found something. A recipe!
Otto tells me you're also new to Fairhaven. Did the get back to the land bug bite you too?
Well, not like it bit you. I mostly came to take care of my grandmother.
Hazel, right? I heard that she passed away recently. My condolences.
Just when I thought I had the refreshing beverage market cornered, Emmy and Finn went and opened a lemonade stand. Kids these days. Man, ruthless.
Am I ready for bed?
We'll be able to fix up this coop, no problem. But you'll need to clear out all the trees and rocks from the area I've roped off. Got it? You come back and let me know when you've cleared out all the trees and rocks there, and then we can talk business. Okay, I'll get started fixing up that old coop right away. Should only take a day or so. Marty seems nice enough, but his boots, they look like the kind you'd buy from some downtown boutique in the city. Not a rancher's boots, you know?
Wow.
I'm all out of strength. I could eat some. Should I go to bed?
Is it? It is! A recipe! I found something. A recipe!
That carpenter fellow, Parker, told me that you're the one to thank for helping repair the bridge to reopen the mountain pass. Although the mayor certainly seemed keen to take all the credit.
Oh, what's this? A recipe?
Thank you.
the new rancher.
No, I am not going to eat his livestock. I have more self-control than that.
I was just going to ask if you'd met him yet.
Oh.
I must say, you were the most captivating Summertide star I've ever seen.
Stop! You were gonna make me blush!
Oh, that only makes you more charming, doesn't it?
No matter how many times I dust off Angus's clothes, he always gets them covered in flour and breadcrumbs again. But I don't mind. I love fussing over him. And he loves to be fussed over.
Hey, heard there's a new rancher. Marty something or other.
Word travels fast in this town.
Yeah, well, Thomas said something about one of Marty's sheep escaping and eating the lettuce that just sprouted in Thomas's garden.
Oh no.
This is going to go really well. I can already tell.
Oh, sun's out, buns out!
Whoa there, Kai!
Oh, hey, I totally meant hamburger buns. A sunny summer day is the best for throwing meat on the grill.
Thank you.
time for bed. Kitty, kitty. That, didn't you, kitty? Time for walking slow has passed. Lighten my feet and make me fast.
Out of all the ranchers Otto could have handpicked to move into the ranch, he chose Marty? I asked if his animal husbandry program had any classes on sustainable ranching, and he said, I'll make things sustainable one day, once I get this place off the ground. We all know what one day means, Marty Emerson.
Are you here to buy your first chick?
Yes, if they're still available.
Oh, they sure are. I wouldn't mind someone taking a few of them off my hands. I mean, they're cute the first few days after hatching, but once they really get to pooping.
Are you trying to make me change my mind?
No! Sorry, just running my mouth. Just like you asked for. A single chick. Oh, no. I shouldn't say that, should I? That's offensive. Here is one young chicken.
I think it's fine in this context.
Now, what would you like to call her?
play?
That's definitely a name. I also brought you some feed, free of charge. You fixed up my ranch, after all. This is the least I could do.
That's very kind of you.
Remember, you have to feed your animals every day. They're just like us, turns out. If you take good care of this chick, she'll eventually turn into a laying hen. Omelets for breakfast every day. Oh, and once you've gotten a handle on chickens, I can sell you cows, too. But for that, you better get Parker to build you a barn. Here's a blueprint. Stop by my ranch if you want to buy animals or some feed for them.
I could make this whole area a place for gardening, but you'll need to clear out all the trees and rocks from the area I've roped off. Got it? You come back and let me know when you've cleared out all the trees and rocks there, and then we can talk business.
This looks like a key to the next level.
This is liquor.
I've been so in the weeds with bar suppliers lately, I haven't had time for anything else. You know, you really saved me here. This place is so much quieter than it was back when the mining company was still open. If Pa were here, he would take one look around and declare our bar dead.
Hey, there's people here. It's at least, like, a zombie bar.
Brains.
I wish it weren't such a pain getting to Fairhaven. I'd have my brothers visit all the time. Maybe I could get Francis's brother to visit, too. They could patch things up. I still don't know why Francis and Fabio don't talk, to be honest.
I found something. A recipe! For bed. Such a good cat. I'm all out of store. I could eat some.
Nice! Seriously, Doe, this really helps. Thanks, Tara!
This is very special. You're clearly a woman of many talents.
Sometimes I make Sebastian rub my feet after work. He hates it.
I mean, I do understand his point of view.
But hey, now I don't have to. I've been going to the onsen instead. You and Kim are lifesavers.
Am I sure this is the Acolyte Witch? I'll have to make another potion and explain myself if I'm wrong. Here you go.
Violet. Yes! You figured it out! What gave me away? Now you're really one of us. I know it's a bit intimidating being the newest member, but I can already tell you're gonna do great.
New girl, want to join me for coffee? Sophia's slop chips are lekker.
Damon, do you ever get tired of having to keep such late hours all the time?
Yeah, you read my mind to tell you the truth. I'll be honest, I'm getting sick of the night owl life. I remember when I was a kid, getting ready for school in the mornings, while my pa snored on the couch. He used to sleep there so he wouldn't wake my ma up when he got in. I don't want my kids to have that kind of relationship with me, you know? Not that I'm ready for kids, but, you know, someday.
I understand.
Well, thanks for letting me ramble.
You sure you want a simple fella like me to have this?
Sweet. What should I bring? Maybe berry smoothies?
Thank you.
If the wellspring is nearby, does that mean I can visit it?
Oh, of course not. The wellspring is absolute magic. That is why magic courses through every leaf and pebble in the gloaming. Only very experienced witches, or very old fae, can make it to the center of the gloaming.
I'll be honest, I've heard of werewolves before, fairies and goblins too, but not Kurupiras. Are Kurupiras a kind of goblin or something?
That's silly. No. We are Kurupiras. Nothing more, nothing less. Though we survive on the same magic as our goblin friends.
Harry always gets excited to see if we'll receive offerings during the summer festival. Milk and honey are fine, I suppose, but how come nobody leaves books as offerings?